What I want to do is introduce iPhase. We'll be focusing on the visual system, the vestibular system, and upgrading our movement work as well, with the whole goal of working toward integration. iPhase, by definition, is really the phase where we talk about the integration of multiple systems with regards to movement, with regards to posture and pain. We are continually adding layers of distinction to understanding brain function, understanding neuroplasticity, identifying underperforming neural systems. You have the opportunity to consciously direct the evolution of your brain. The way that we direct our attention, the way that we direct the intensity of our work is going to determine the eventual outcome. So we want to become experts in understanding how to practically apply concepts in the work that we do to improve neuroplasticity. What I need you to know right now is behavior modification is really job number one if you are a movement professional. It doesn't matter if you're trying to change pain, if you're trying to rehabilitate a movement or a motor control problem, if you're trying to do sports performance work. Ultimately, what we have to understand is that in order to achieve your goal, we have to change your behavior. I consider behavioral change work in the same realm as vision drills and vestibular drills. It may seem a little bit weird in a fitness environment to go from vision drills to vestibular work to movement drills to behavior, but they are all interconnected. In iPhase, we're going to take the basic motor control drills of R-phase and we're going to complicate them significantly. Everything in iPhase is about reverse engineering from a movement perspective, a visual perspective, a vestibular perspective, because it is not just the gross positioning that matters, but instead, all of the systems involved from the local motor control, the local mobility, all the way up through the vestibular system, the visual system, and then how they are integrating. What all this led to was building out what's called the iPhase movement template. And the question was, body part by body part, what was required in order for them to perform? When you understand this, it allows you to become incredibly creative in how you're going to build motor control exercises and other drills for your clients. The other thing to recognize is that this template is an analysis tool to understand what are the different components that they need to achieve in order to complete this particular task. In iPhase, we're going to connect what we're going through here to what you've already done at R-phase. By the end of iPhase, you should have a better idea of how does your current movement curriculum impact cerebellum, brainstem, and cortical function? How can you tweak what you're already teaching in order to go after these areas? And then finally, if you just get really good at understanding frontal lobe, cerebellar interactions, brainstem interactions, you are well ahead of the game for being able to figure out how to help your clients be successful. So that's what Z-Health is all about. Take that complex information and say, this is what you do with it when you're standing in front of another human being.